State insurer PhilHealth blames the pandemic for its slow processing of medical claims. President and CEO Dante Guerin says PhilHealth is processing an average of 39,000 claims daily. That's more than last year's daily average of 31,000 claims. State health insurer is also suffering manpower shortages.
We blame it again on the pandemic because we have a limited locomotive. Some of our people got sick. As a matter of fact, some of our people even died. No? And we cannot tell everybody that we have this problem. So we are doing something about this.
In August, PhilHealth said that it has nearly 13 billion pesos in unpaid claims in different stages of processing. The Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines had warned its members may not renew their PhilHealth accreditation next year if issues with the payment of claims are not resolved. Believe vaccinated travelers from so-called green countries no longer need to undergo facility-based quarantine upon arriving in the Philippines. They will, however, have to show a negative RT-PCR test taken within 72 hours before their arrival. Vaccinated individuals who fail to comply with the test before travel requirement will have to undergo quarantine until they get a negative result on the fifth day. This rule will also apply to the unvaccinated, the partially vaccinated, and to those whose vaccinations cannot be independently verified. As for fully inoculated Filipinos, they too can skip facility-based quarantine, though they will need to self-monitor for any COVID-19 symptoms until their 14th day. Travelers can present certificates from VaxCertPH, the Bureau of Quarantine, the World Health Organization, or from the country where they were vaccinated. But Health Secretary Francisco Duque III says that he will raise some of these concerns over the new policy.
I was told that in some countries they're doing this now, but those countries can afford to do it because their national vaccination coverage is more than 70%, whereas we are only at 30%. And not all travelers are going passing through NCR. Some travelers are going to Davao, to Cebu, to other airports. So that's a cause for concern, no? So I'm going to raise this later once the IATF reconvenes for this week.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque III acknowledges the importance of the Senate's probe into the government's allegedly anomalous pandemic deals. During Wednesday's Senate hearing on the Health Department's budget, Duque admitted that President Rodrigo Duterte should not have barred his cabinet officials from participating in the Blue Ribbon Committee's investigation. He says that he's even willing to take the matter up with Malacañang.
We are one with them, and as I have manifested to the Senate, that we're ready to support. You know, any questions that they will ask, we could probably send them the documents or give us a written question. We'll write them back. We have submitted subpoena, duces tecum. We are very much in support of measures that will ferret out the truth.